Army runs away from these things, our space pirates try to hightail it as well. Or they stop and walk slowly in the other direction rather than make it to their only escape route.
Idiots on level 5. Sweet, delicious idiots on level 5.
So this guy, whose name you can't remember, gets axed off and they come across suspect number 1.
Don't shoot! It's in front of the hall!
It's okay. I'll give you guys a few minutes to run.
Come on, man. Time to go. Time to go!
Get back!
Few more minutes. Yeah, I should probably chase after them. Ugh, I'm so distracted, I just can't focus. You know, I think my mind was just distracted by that ad I saw earlier today. How'd it go again? Yeah, that was it. Okay, I think they've had time to simmer in their own sweat. Let me just use the psychic alien powers I just figured out we had to not figure out that one of my own kind is about to shoot me in the mouth.
What the fuck?
I better still get a snow cone!
Was it everything you hoped for?
What is your obsession with turning this into a lesbo flick?
So, who do I have to fuck to get off this boat?
Well, we all know who you like to fuck! Seriously, where did this come from?
Let's get out of here.
Now wait a second here! She was the host for these monsters! She's not human.
I wanted a horse, not a pony!
She comes.
So they come across the wheelchair guy. Yeah, I know he has a name, but let's face it, you're just gonna call him the wheelchair guy. And they also stumble across the other cloning experiments before Ripley was made. Now, this scene is creative and allows for some cool visuals, but when you really get down to it, it's totally pointless. Would you really miss anything if this part of the story was cut out? Aside from deformed Ripley booby?
A painless poison will do.
And I'm sure this will in no way attract other aliens aboard the ship at all. Whatever you do, don't draw the aliens' attention except for very loudly destroying as much equipment as possible.
Very stealthy, very stealthy.
Must be a chick thing.
They come across one of the prisoners who has an alien inside of him, and like morons, they decide to bring him along. I'm so looking forward to not getting attached to this character because obviously he's going to die. You have the same chances as a lawyer in a theme park filled with dinosaurs. Odds aren't in your favor, guy.
I'm okay. I'm okay.
They come across a flooded area where they discover the aliens have set a trap for them to birth more babies. Oh shit, that's bad. As you remember in the first film, once those things get on, they never come off. The more and more you pull, the tighter and tighter it gets. Or she just rips it off like waxing a mustache. Did you even see the other alien movies? Were these things really like just swatting a housefly off of you the whole time? Annoying. Luckily, the black guy from earlier still has calculated aiming that would make Basil of Baker Street blush.
Multiplied by the square root of an isosceles triangle, dividing Goodenough's principle of opposing forces in motion, and adjusting for the difference in equilibrium.
This allows them to start climbing up just as one of the doctors from before turns against them.
You really are way too trusting.
No! Allow me to put this in my bitch later folder. Trust me, I'll put it to good use. So the alien jumps out of the water and tries to follow our heroes. You're telling me that this guy can hit with impeccable accuracy any angle, any position, knocking off of every solid object he can find, but a 7-foot alien standing right the fuck in front of him is constantly throwing off his aim? Do you need him to wear a giant bullseye on his head? Good God, this is embarrassing! finally managed to shoot the damn thing, but it hangs onto his foot, which he could easily kick off, but for some reason he decides to separate himself to save the rest of the crew.
Go!
Let us have a moment of silence for that black guy.
You know, I don't think that fall would have killed him.
Nah, he's dead.
There's no other aliens down there to get him.
No, he's dead.
He could easily just swim out of there any chance he wanted.
Why can't you just accept the incredibly rare fact that a black guy has died in a horror film?
Even all the facehuggers were destroyed.
You racist? How does that even...
Sure.
But it turns out Cole made it out okay, despite the fact that she was shot. Why? Because she's a robot, of course.
You're an Autobot. Robots designed by robots, right?
And alright, this leads me to my bitch later folder. First off, if she's a robot, why did a bullet hurt her? The robots in the past never took so long to recover from anything like that. Second, since she fell in the water, why didn't the alien attack her when it had the chance? They're smart, they know she's a threat. And third, if she could swim out of the water, okay, why the fuck couldn't the black guy? You racist?
I don't think you know what that word means.
So after figuring that out, Ripley gets caught by the aliens, but is surprisingly not harmed.
Hey!
Ripley!
Things get even worse when the doctor catches up with the crew and holds Cole hostage.
Nobody moves, or I put a cap right where this little droid's brain is.
Go ahead, she's a fucking robot!
Now drop the weapon!
Yeah, sure, drop the weapons. It's not like robots can survive anything extreme, except being shot in the chest, being torn in half, and getting your head fucking decapitated. But aside from that, robots are very sensitive. Be careful. Here's another goofy scene. The prisoner from earlier feels the alien starting to come out, so what does he do? What anyone would do if they felt something starting to pop out of their stomach? Gets up, goes for a walk, beats the living shit out of the guy, and then has the alien burst through his head. Well, give him an A for creativity, but this makes no sense! I don't remember John Hurt going through anything like this in the first Alien movie. Oh my god, I feel something about to burst out of my chest! Oh, that's strange, I have a sudden burst of energy. Hell, I want to jazzercise! Oh yes, do a little typo. Up, it's kicking.
Hello, my baby! Hello, my honey!
And just when you thought things couldn't get any sillier in this movie, we find out that Brad Dourif is still alive, throwing a really fucking last-minute plot exposition that Ripley's DNA mixed with the Queen's DNA now allows her to give birth to a new life form. Oh, and you thought his acting as Chucky was subtle? Take a look at this little piece of Shakespearean gold.
You are a beautiful butterfly.
I have no idea why I'm cheerfully invested. But the new baby doesn't take to her mother kindly.
No. Not the mama!
Oh, look. Look, beautiful, beautiful little baby.
You know, his performance is like a human representation of alien porn fan fiction. I really have no idea what's going on through his mind, and I think for the sake of all humanity, it should remain that way. He should just come with a sign saying, Brad Dourif. No questions, damn it, no questions. So Ripley gets away and jumps onto the ship leaving for Earth, but of course that snot bubble sneaks aboard too.
Put it down!
I really love how they try to make you feel for this thing you were introduced to in the last 10 minutes of the movie. Especially when they give him these big puppy dog eyes.
I just want to eat humanity and devour brains. Is that a crime?
Even at his most psychotic, they still try to throw that shit in. It's pretty emotionally clustered.
I just want to play with the puppies.
You cocksucking motherfucker!
Mommy, why would you do this to me?
I'll eat your ass in hell!
But they shoot a hole in the window, which forces him to literally get sucked out.
I want a princess castle!
a hole in the window of a ship re-entering Earth's atmosphere wouldn't cause any complications at all. So they re-enter fine and look over the new world they have to explore. And after all that lesbian buildup, we finally get our gay kiss for the movie. Fuck you. So that was Alien Resurrection. What the hell happened? It's so weird watching a movie franchise like this go so bizarrely bad. Especially with, to be fair, a lot of good people working on it. The story has a million holes, the characters are just there to die, the idea of mixing Ripley's DNA with the alien is interesting but doesn't add to much, if anything at all. Some of the gross-out deaths are creatively over the top, but for the most part, it's just a lame flick. And a really disappointing way to end what is now the poorly named Alien trilogy. Personally, I'll take my chances with Prometheus. After all, when has Ridley Scott ever directed a bad movie? Let me dream! I'm the Nostalgia Critic guy. Remember it so you don't have to.
Hello, my baby. Hello, my honey. Hello, my ragtime gal. Send me a kiss, my wire. Baby, my heart's on fire. If you refuse me, honey, you lose me. Then you'll be left alone. Oh, baby, telephone and tell me I'm your own.
Check, please.
Must be a chick thing.